I'm the first daughter of two. I live in Cengkareng, Jakarta Barat, and my hobbies are listening music and watching film. I'm sorry, Mister. I think you mute your.
What kind of movie that you like to watch?
All of movie, but now I really like Emily in Paris in Netflix.
Oh, okay. Okay, nice. What is your dream in the future?
In the future, I want to build my own tax consultant.
Wow.
But in the short term, my short-term dream is I want to continue my education in magister.
Okay.
Degree.
Nice. Will it going to be in Indonesia or abroad country?
Maybe yeah. In Indonesia first, and then after that I continue with another major in abroad.
Okay. Cool then. Cool. Okay. What about you, Gladys? Thank you, Mbak Monica. Now, Gladys.
Yes.
Yeah, Gladys. Yeah, can you introduce about yourself so that we know about you? And by the way, can we see your face? Is it bad hair day for you? Oh, there. Hello, Gladys. Okay, can you introduce about yourself? Like your name, where you school?
My name is Gladys Julita Margaret, and you can call me Gladys.
Hello.
I'm 12 years old, and I'm junior high school. My hobby is swimming and dancing.
Okay. What kind of dance? Traditional dance or modern dance? Like hip hop? What kind of dance that you like? Gladys, what kind of dance that you like? Traditional dance or modern dance, like hip-hop? Hip-hop dance? Or you just dance in front of TikTok? Which one is it? Oh, yeah. Well, Gladys, hello.
Yes.
What is your dream in the future? What do you want to be?
I want to be a teacher.
Oh, you want to be a teacher? What kind of teacher? What subject that you want to teach? English or math or biology or physics?
Math.
Math. So you like math?
Yes.
Nice. You can be a tax consultant also, you know, if you like math. But Monica here. Because you have to be dealing with numbers. And seriously, I'm bad at numbers. My math only like 50 when I was senior high school. Really, really bad at math.
Yes. I'm bad in English.
Yeah. See? Okay, thank you, Gladys. Now, Deshane. Hey, Deshane.
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you introduce about yourself to all of us here?
Okay. My name is Deshane Haga. I am 14 years old. I live in Medan, and I'm a student.
Okay, what about your hobby? What's your hobby, your dislike? Your dream in the future?
My hobby are drawing and painting.
Your dream in the future? What do you want to be in the future?
I still don't know.
Okay. Yeah, okay, now, Devon. Devon, you're still there, Devon? Is that picture of potato? Potato face. Yeah, anyway, can you introduce about yourself?
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
My name on Harbert City Morang.
Okay.
I'm from Medan. I'm 13 years old. My hobby is playing football.
Oh, it is the same like Farel. Playing football. Okay, playing football in real life or playing football in PlayStation?
Real life.
Okay. Right. Yeah, that's the questions again. What about right now? Since right now is there is corona everywhere, can you play football in real life? Farel, no? So you can only play football in your house. Can you play football in your house? Your mom will not get to me. Can you even play football in your house? Your of course, your mother will go into angry at you. All right. What do you want to be, Devon, in the future?
I still know it.
You still don't know, of course. It's okay. You are going to find the answer later. Okay, Mr. Anton. Mr. Anton, what do you want to be when you have already grown? Oh, you have already grown. Okay, can you introduce about yourself, Mr. Anton? Unmute yourself first. Unmute yourself. You're still muted, Mr. Anton.
Hello?
Okay, we can hear you now.
Yeah, okay. Okay, Mr. Teguh, thanks for the time you give me. My name is Anton. My nickname is also Anton. I live in Payakumbuh, West Sumatra. If you ever been to West Sumatra, maybe you can go to Harau Valley. Harau Valley is a waterfall in my regency.
Okay.
Harau, Lembah Harau. Eh? So my house is about 10 kilometers from there.
Okay.
I work in health department in Kabupaten 50 Kota Regency. My duty is to pharmacy product storage.
Oh, I see.
Medicine like tablet, capsule.
Okay.
So I distribute all the medicine pharmacy product to public health center in all public center in 50 Kota Regency.
All right.
Yeah. So my hobby, yeah, watching YouTube. Okay. Watching YouTube movie, yeah. Horror movie, thriller movie. Right. Reading novel.
Okay, nice.
Novel by Sidney Sheldon, Stranger in the Mirror,
okay.
Batu Berlian, yeah. So in reading novel in English is still difficult for me now. Yeah. I have a novel written by Charles Dickens, like Oliver Twist, but I cannot read that. Yeah,
well, I still have a problem. Well, actually, I also have the novel of Harry Potter from book 1 until book 7 in Bahasa Indonesia.
Oh, yeah.
In Bahasa Indonesia and English. From book 1 until book 7 in PDF.
Yeah.
All of you PDF. Want? I can share it to all of you if you want.
Send me.
Okay. I'm going to share it in the group. So if you would like to have it, just download it by yourself in group WhatsApp later on.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So you like Harry Potter also?
Oh, like Harry Potter? I like Harry Potter, yeah.
Cool. Oh yeah, sir. About the since you said that you are actually working in a pharmacy or drugs industry, do you think the government has already actually made the cure for the corona already or not yet? Since you are working in medicine.
You mean is government ready to treat the corona victim? You mean that?
I mean, does the drugs has already been made by the government? Because I read the news from all over the world. Every government from all over the world are still looking for the cure to cure this corona.
Yeah. I think the procedure of corona therapy is not found.
Not found yet.
Not found yet. But some of the medicine, antivirus like acetaminophen, is still one of the best choice now. All before right, we get right. the real medicine, yeah. Okay, dexamethasone as okay. Corticosteroid now okay. is also used by the heavy the victim of corona with okay. the patient who have to stay in hospital mm-hmm. they get dexamethasone. I think Donald Trump, United States President, is yeah. use dexamethasone also for his okay. treatment. Now the true treatment, the right treatment, the best treatment mm-hmm. now is still not found yet.
Not found yet. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
not found yet. Yeah. Okay. The medicine like kayu putih oil. Mm-hmm. And traditional is still not responsible, cannot be trusted. Yeah.
Okay.
Still, it is used just to make the patient
feels
strong.
Better.
Yeah, okay. yeah.
it is pretty much the same like placebo effect, yeah?
Placebo. Yeah, like placebo. Yeah, not maybe better than placebo. Better than placebo, eh?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it seems. Thank you, Mr. Anton.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you. It seems Mbak Monica still busy with the work, yeah. There's some deadline that you have to finish this tonight.
No, but I must communication with my partner.
You have to communicate with your department. Okay, nice. Okay, Mr. Chandra. Mr. Chandra? Hello, Mr. Chandra. You are still there, Mr. Chandra?
Yes, Mr. Chandra.
Yeah, Mr. Chandra. You are not going home yet? You're still in your office? Until what time do you usually work in your office?
Yes. I have class until 6 p.m. Oh,
so it is every day until 6? From what time do you
start?
Just for a month. Okay. You are right now working in PLN in which city again right now? In Jakarta?
No, in Medan.
Oh, in Medan. Okay. What about the condition in Medan, sir? What about the corona there? Is there like green zone or yellow zone, orange zone or red zone? Is there any, like night curfew, night hour there? Is there anything like that?
Actually, red zone, but mm-hmm. yeah, after 2 weeks, we work from home because there were two employees getting coronavirus. So for that, we work from okay. office, and uh-huh. right now uh-huh. there is no schedule about work from home. So all the uh-huh. employees right now, yeah, keep the control, stay. Uh-huh.
Is there any workers from your company that has already been infected by this virus?
Yeah.
How many?
Two wow. employees.
But they have already been cured in the hospital?
Still treatment, mister.
Oh, still treatment in the hospital. Right. Okay, hopefully everything's going to be get fine, yeah, in yes. Medan. Oh, yeah, in which part of Medan are you right now? In which part of Medan? Because yeah. the Shen and Davon also in Medan. They said that they are in Medan, the Shen and Davon.
Yeah, Medan Selayang sub-district, Mr.
The sub-district.
Yes.
Okay. Is that your coworkers?
Hmm?
Is that your coworkers? They're not going home yet.
That's my colleague. my colleagues.
Okay, okay, okay. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. So it seems that from this class, well, since not everyone is coming yet right now, there are still some people who have not yet able to join us because this sometimes also happen, especially like during this kind of afternoon time like this. Sometimes there are some of us that cannot join because they have to do something with their work in their office, for example, or they have some things to do. So maybe we are going to see something like this happen in our meeting. Sometimes there are some of us can attend the meeting. Sometimes there are some of us cannot attend the meeting. That's normal. It's okay. From what I see, from the way all of you are speaking, is actually quite good already, since this actually extended speaking. It is not basic speaking. So mainly, I can see that the main reason is actually to not only just to improve, but mainly it's also at least to maintaining skills that you are that you already have right now. Because even if we have already good English already, but if we do not see someone or we don't talk to someone in English, then somehow our English skill will going to be degraded over and over again if we don't see or we cannot communicate with someone in English. So that is why sometimes if, for example, let me ask you this. For example, if you're trying to speak in English with your friends in your office or in your house or in your neighborhood, do they will going to support you or do they will going to mocking you? Like for example, ah ngapain lo ngomong bahasa Inggris, belagu lo, keminggris lo. Do they say that like that to you most of the time?
Yes.
No. Ah yeah, because you are working with foreigners, of course.
Absolutely, sir.
What about you, like Mr. Anton and Mr. Chandra? And already, when you are trying to speak in English with your friends, with your neighbor, yeah, do they mocking you like that?
I have no
absolutely
friend.
Absolutely.
No friend speak in English in my office.
But if you try to speak in English with them, what is going to happen?
No.
They cannot, right?
They don't like, usually, yeah, generally, they don't like to speak in English.
See? See, that's why.
So but, that's why. But when I was in Padang, in Central West Sumatra,
yeah,
I ever taught in Pharmacy Academy.
Okay.
Yeah, I practice my English every day with the lecturer there.
Nice.
But in my office now, they are still young. Most of them don't like to speak in English. That's why I joined with your room in order to speak in English.
Most of young people like to speak English, but
yeah, they're very young. Yeah, younger than I am. Yeah, they are most of them under 30 years old.
Oh, okay, and they cannot speak in English.
Yeah.
I mean, it is supposed to be younger people, right? Who can speak in English?
Yeah.
I don't know. For example, like Farel here, Farel, Dashen, Radis. They are very young and they can speak in English, because sometimes most of the time it is older people who cannot speak in English. So it is very rare for me to see like Mr. Anton, Mr. Chandra, who is actually quite older but still can speak in English. That's quite impressive. It's really, really impressive.
I haven't practiced my English more than 20 years old, Mr. Tegu.
Wow.
More than 20 years old. Yeah.
Okay. How do you practice your English, sir?
How do I practice?
Yeah. I mean, just by watching YouTube or?
Yeah, now by watching YouTube, there is a English study in YouTube. Also watching movie for my listening.
Of course,
yeah.
Of course.
And to practice, I have no friend. Yeah. A friend in my office.
Okay.
I have a friend to practice my English about 3 or 4 years ago, but she moved to another department. Yeah.
Okay.
So it is impossible for me to call her every day.
All right. Nice. Yeah, Farel, you want to ask something to Mr. Anton?
Anton.
Yeah. Okay, Farel. How are you, Farel? I'm Sai with Farel, Mr. Teguh. Well, Farel, what do you want to ask to me?
You are from Payakumbu, right?
Yeah, from Payakumbu.
My grandpa is from there also.
Oh yeah. Well, where is he? Where is?
Kota Baru.
Kota Baru.
Kota Baru.
Kota Baru Simalanggang or Kota Baru? Kota Baru Simalanggang, yeah.
I don't know.
Kota Baru Simalanggang, yeah. I know that place. Not so far from here.
Oh.
Kota Baru, yeah. Maybe Kota Baru Simalanggang. It is about 7 kilometers from my house. Tell your grandpa that I live in Lago Basilang, eh?
So Farel is actually Padangnese also. Half Padangnese.
Padang.
Grandpa, Bapa.
Only your grandpa. Okay. How long you have been living in Jakarta?
Your face like my grandson.
Oh yeah. Oh, okay, my grandson. Nice, okay, very okay. Happy to talk with you.
All right.
Is he also black like I am?
Dark. Okay.
Huh? Yeah, brown. Yeah, not black.
Dark.
I don't right. believe, but you, your skin is very white. Eh? I don't believe your grandpa look like.
Sometimes it doesn't necessarily mean like that. You know what? Like for example, my son. See, my skin is dark, yeah. but my skin also white like Farel. My son also white like Farel. Yeah. But me, look at me. I'm dark.
Maybe you're white. Maybe your grandpa Kota Baru, yeah, Kota Baru Simalanggang, Farel. Kota Baru Simalanggang, 7 kilometers from Kumbu.
All right.
Ramayana.
Near
from Ramayana.
Oh, it's very near from my house. Only 2 kilometers from my house. Yeah, tell your grandpa that I live in Lago Basilang. I have a pharmacy store in Lago Basilang. If he need medicine, he can ask me.
He can get it for free?
What? Yeah. Free for the cheap medicine like paracetamol, yeah, okay. JTM.
Or vitamin C.
Vitamin C, yeah. What's the name of your grandpa?
Hajri Mahmudi.
Hajri Mahmudi. Okay.
What is the name of your pharmacy, Mr. Anton? The name of your pharmacy?
Asda Medical Pharma, Mr. Teguh.
Asda Medical Pharma. Okay, Asda Medical Pharma. Tell that to your grandpa.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Now,
may I ask something to how many time do you visit your grandpa every year or
My grandpa now is on Gorontalo.
Oh, Gorontalo.
Oh, it's Gorontalo. Wow.
Stay.
What is he doing in Gorontalo? Is he there by himself? Only by himself? Alone?
Alone.
You ever been to?
Yes.
Yeah. The next one is you go to Pego.
Yes.
So
hello. Hello? Hello? Can you guys hear me? Hello?
Hi.
Farel said our teacher has gone, Mr. Teguh.
Huh?
Farel said our teacher has gone. Say.
Teacher has gone? What
Farel said our teacher has gone. Say.
No, I don't have. what kind of gun? What kind of gun? That real gun?
Has gun. Go.
Oh, has gun. No, my internet connection. I'm having problem with my internet connection. Yeah. All right. Yeah. So,
I have one question for Monica, Mr. Teguh.
Okay. Yes. Go ahead.
Yes.
Talking about tax, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the small industry, some of the small seller get the free tax in the corona time like now, but some of them cannot get the free tax. So what do you do? How to take the free tax, especially for the PPX versus for PPH pasal 4 ayat 2, yeah. The final tax. Or half person from the onset.
I think actually my specialty in
foreigner.
PPH, yes, for foreigner. So I don't know a lot of about the PPH 4 ayat 2.
Oh yeah, okay.
And then or maybe you can read the regulation. And then like sometimes the tax office will you have to like register or register some document to show them that you have that you harusnya dapat pengurangan pajak.
Yeah, yeah.
I think because I'm sorry because my specialty is only in foreigner who okay. works in Indonesia.
No problem. Yeah, yeah. PPH pasal 4 ayat 2 is also for the seller have omset not more than 4.8 billion rupiah. But in this corona time, some of them can get the free tax.
Mm.
They don't have to pay tax, but I didn't get it. Yeah? So I don't know why. Yeah? Maybe I have to register, or maybe yes. maybe I have to ask the account representative in the office.
Yes.
What about you, Mr. Chandra? Is there anything that you would like to ask to other participant here, Mr. Chandra?
No, Mr. Thank you, Mr. Because I have program.
Oh, you are doing your job right now. Okay.
I have the other class, Mr. Because the same time, Mr. I don't know about the extended speaking.
Okay. So, how many class you are taking actually? How many online class that you are actually taking?
Today I have four online class programs.
Wow, that's a lot. All right.
Yeah, but in the morning mm-hmm. at 7 and
okay.
at noon
mm-hmm.
12:30 after that. Okay. 3:30.
And all of them are about English.
Yeah, about English, Mr.
Wow. You are really serious in improving your English, yeah? Maybe that is also one of the positive side one of the positive side of having a corona pandemic like this. You can learn anything from online. Because before Corona, we never thought about something like this, right? Before Corona, we never thought about something like this. But only after Corona, then all of English course are using online platform. That's great, actually.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Now about our program, before we're going to close it, because this is already 4:30. Before we close it, I'm going to say that I'm going to ask you this. Is it okay if, for example, in some of the days, we are going to talk not only about speaking, but we will also we're going to talk about pronunciations, for example. You know pronunciations?
Yeah.
Pronunciations is like pengucapan, how the way to say words in English correctly, so that you are not going to say English, but English, for example, like that. Or, for example, when Mr. Anton said grandpa, it is actually grandpa, not grandpa. Sounds
grandpa.
Like somehow I hear it grandpa. Okay, now for example, so English, not English or English. There are also some people say that English, eng. It is supposed to be English. Now there is English. Only it is. There is just small example, but probably someday we are also we are going to talk also about pronunciations and sometimes also we are going to talk about idiomatical expression. Do you know idiomatical expression? Idiomatical expressions, for example, like, hey, what about the exam today? Oh, the exam is piece of cake, for example. That is idiomatic expressions, phrase.
How to break the ice.
Yeah, I know, sir.
Yeah, you know, yeah, piece of cake. Yeah, the exam is piece of cake. It's just the selmek in bahasa Indonesia. Ah, dia orangnya panjang tangan, dia orangnya tebal muka, muka tembok. This idiomatic expression in bahasa Indonesia. Of course, for native speaker of Bule who are actually learning bahasa Indonesia, they will going to have difficulty in understanding about idiomatic expression in bahasa Indonesia. The same also with us Indonesian who like to learn about English. Sometimes we also will going to find difficulty in understanding about idiomatic expression in English, because sometimes idiomatic expressions, the way how it is written and the meaning is completely different, right? For example, panjang tangan and mencuri. For Bule, yeah, they will get confused. What? Long hand? What do you mean long hand, for example? Or wall face? What do you mean wall face? They will go to get confused. The same also, like for example, what about the exam? Oh, the exam is piece of cake. For Indonesia, we're going to what? Ujiannya sepotong kue. What do you mean by ujiannya sepotong kue? So that is just the examples. So do you know what is the meaning of piece of cake in here? Anybody know?
It's easy.
Easy. Yeah. See, the meaning of idiomatic expressions and the way how it is written is completely different. So sometimes if we haven't known about that, we are going to get confused. Okay. So that's going to be some of the things that we are going to learn in this 20 days class, in this 1 month class. Which is not only we're going to talk or to have discussion like this, speaking like this, but sometimes we will also really going to talk about idiomatical expressions. Sometimes we're going to talk about pronunciation practice also. Sometimes we will also really going to talk about grammatical. Do you still remember about tenses, right?
Yeah, remember.
16 tenses, okay. Sometimes we will also really going to rewind about that. I think it is not something new for you when you are talking about tenses. You have already known about tenses, but we just will going to refresh it again so that we are going to remember on which kind of tenses that you are going to use when you would like to speak about this or you would like to speak about that. So is that okay? If we are going to have our course to be like that?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So it is not going to be every day we're going to be about speaking, but sometimes also we will going to be talk about idiomatical expressions, grammar, and also about pronunciation practice. Okay, maybe probably since today we have already have introduction like this, probably tomorrow we will going to talk about more pronunciation practice. Agree? Okay.
So what about the topic?
Oh.
I'm
sorry.
Is there many book?
Actually, no. Even I have already changed of the material from written materials into digital material. So some of the material I have already put it on YouTube, for example, or in some website. So that I will going to share the link. Because if you are using online course like this, of course I cannot share the book. Of course I have to share. I have already changed all of the format in written text into like digital, like YouTube or website. So those are all PDF probably. So those are the things that I'm going to share. So during every meetings, when it's talking about pronunciation practice or grammatical tenses, or when it's about idiomatical expression, of course I'm going to share some links that would be related to the materials. Either the links were going to be about website or about PDF or about YouTube video, for example, which I hope will going to be helpful for you to improve your English ability in the future. Okay, is that clear for today?
Sir, yes. Maybe I would join late because I had another regular subject from university. Yeah.
Okay, it's okay. You could join late.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so thank you for today's meeting, for this introduction.
Mr. Tegu?
Yes.
Mr. Tegu?
Yes, what is it, Mr.
What our topic? Tomorrow, maybe.
Oh, we are going to talk about ourselves. Pronunciation practice, sir. I'm going to give the material.
Pronunciation.
Yeah, pronunciation practice.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, pronunciation practice. Even though I believe that for this extended speaking class, most of you have already like maybe like 80% or 70%, 80% has already had good pronunciations, but it's going to be also going to be very helpful to know about how the way to read this, for example. What is the difference between cemilan dan ular? Snake and snake, for example. So you have to able to differentiate about that. Or for example, do you know paus? What is paus in English? Do you know what is paus in English?
Whale.
Mr. Anton?
Yeah.
Paus, what is paus in English?
In English.
Yeah.
No. Farel, you know Farel?
Hey, don't ask Farel. No, Farel, don't tell.
Yeah, fish.
No, that's ikan. Paus. Paus. Yeah, fish.
Not shark. Shark hiu, yeah.
Shark hiu.
Shark hiu.
Paus is not fish.
Oh yeah, mammals. Paus is actually mammal. What about you, Monica? Monica, do you know what is paus in English?
Well.
You said well. Okay. Duchenne, how?
Well.
Duchenne, well. Gladys, how do you say paus? Okay, Gladys, what about you? How do you say paus in English?
Well.
Well, what about Farel? How do you say paus in English?
Whale.
See? whale, not well. Not well. Well is baik-baik saja. Or sumur. Sumur or baik-baik saja. It has to be whale. See? Different sound will going to create different meanings. Different sound will going to create different meanings. I found this mistake when I was teaching in Surabaya International School, like in 2010 when I was teaching in Surabaya International School, when I was going to read this storytelling in front of first grader in Surabaya International School. I was going to tell them the story about whale, and then I said that, do you know what is the biggest animal in the ocean? And then everybody will go into silence, and then I said that, okay, the biggest animal in the ocean is actually well, I said that at the time. That was my mistake. I said well, and then Duncan, first grader from America, he said that, well, what do you mean well? And then I said, well, you know, the biggest animal in the ocean. And then he was kind of like thinking, well, oh, you mean whale. And then I was like, yeah, that's what I meant. I said whale. And then Duncan was like, no, you said well. No, I said whale. Use your ears. I said like that. Luckily, it was like only first grader. Maybe that is the mistake that I made at that time. So it means if you pronounce it differently, if you say it differently, the meaning will going to be different. For example, when you would like to say it, Danau, and then you said, how do you say Danau, for example?
Lake.
See?
Lake.
Lake, Mr. Anton. Lake. Bukan lake. It's not lake, but lake. Lake is cool.
Lake.
Your lack of confidence, for example. Lake. L-A-C-K. Lake. So, see? Different sounds will going to produce different meanings. If you're talking with native speaker, they are going to having some difficulty in understanding you. What do you mean by that, for example? Or for example, the most dangerous one. The most dangerous one. Long sound and short sound. Hey, bagaimana kalau kita pergi ke pantai besok? Ayo kita pergi ke pantai. And then he said that, let's go to the beach. What the? And then the speaker was like, what? Let's go to the beach. Not beach. See, different sounds, you're going to have different meanings. So that is the thing that we are going to study tomorrow. Okay, so tomorrow we're going to have pronunciation practice. Maybe for like students like Farel, who quite fortunate because he's actually studying international school in which all of the lesson is being delivered in English. Just like for me, for example, I have been teaching in Surabaya International School like 3 years at that time, from 2010 to 2012 at that time before I moved to university and becoming a lecturer. Yeah, at that time, since everything is being delivered in English, so even though I learn about pronunciation practice at that time, so, but just by hearing the way how people are saying it in English, I then suddenly know, oh, so this is the way how to say it in English. Maybe probably like Farel, for example, even though I believe Farel never learn about pronunciation practice or phonology, for example, but since it is the language that is being delivered in his school every day, somehow without even learning it, he has already know that, oh, this is the way how to say it. Just for example, also like my son, maybe next time, tomorrow I'm going to bring my son. My son is like 6 years old, who's like in the kindergarten, kindergarten B, kindergarten B, but I have already been talking in English with my son since he was in the first grade. So since he was in his first year old, I mean, because even if my son, until right now, he cannot yet read anything yet. He can only read A, B, C, D until Z and only can count. But he can already speak in English, and the way how he pronounced things also has really been in English, even though he unable to read anything yet. So it is going to be about habits. We are going to make that habits. Okay. The last one who joined us. Hello, Miss Firza. Hello, Mbak
Hello, Firza. Mr. Teguh.
Hello, can you introduce about yourself to all of us here before we are going to close it? Actually, it has already been finished.
I'm very late in the Zoom, yeah.
Okay, since Mbak Fisa has already been here, that. Since Mbak Fisa has already been here, we can close it today. Okay, thank you.
Oh my God.
Okay, Mbak Fisa, can you introduce about yourself?
My name If you want to editing or make the program, please contact me.
You are promoting yourself. I come from
yes, promoting person.
where is your background of your education again? Where is the background of your education again?
What?
Your background of education.
My background education is computer science, science computer.
Oh, so you can make like website. You can make website or like application in Play Store like that. You can make it also.
Yes, sure.
Okay. What about if
I can do 3D?
You can animation. Make 3D. Wow, what? Nice. What about if there is any of us in here would like to make website or 3D animations? Can we have it for free from you?
Sorry, Mister. Reply. Signal error.
Yeah, if you want to make website or, for example, applications from Play Store or 3D animation, can we make it for free from you?
Mm. Just for question about my what? Biarkan mereka bertanya dulu.
Okay. Is there any question that you would like to ask to Mr. to Mbak Firza? Anyone here? Lady Farah, Gladys, Miss Ranto.
Hello, lady.
Hi, Miss.
Yeah, lady, what do you want to ask to Mbak Firza?
My hope to Mbak Firza, maybe sometime she will help me to make a software for storage of my medicine. I hope she will give me the best price for that.
Discount price, yeah?
Discount price.
Can you do that, Mbak Firza?
Yes.
All right. See, you come late and you have already got business deal. You come late and you have already got business deal.
Yeah.
Yes. Nice. But the person me, I can help you.
And also maybe with Mbak Monica also. Mbak Monica working in tax company. Maybe you can make application about tax.
For tax, yeah. How to fill the document easier. Oh, yeah.
That's going to be great.
Okay.
Is there anyone who would like to ask anything to Mbak Firza here? Maybe Farel, you want to ask something? You want to ask something to Mbak Firza?
No.
Okay.
But yes. Mr. Tego.
Yes, sir.
I want Farel to guess my age.
Okay, Farel. Guess
Mr. Antonio. I want Farel mention my age.
Okay, Farel.
How old am I? Farel? How old
is Mr. Anton?
15.
15 is Gladys.
50, yeah. 50. Yeah.
Is it?
48.
Oh, 48.
Yeah. 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 See, he say I am look like
50.
Grandpa. So I think he will guess 70.
Oh yeah, is that your grandpa age? Your grandpa age is 70. 70? Farrell? 72.
72.
Or maybe just the face, Mr. Anton, just the face.
So, so your grandpa look like me this time or when your grandpa still when? Young?
I'm young. Mr. Anton also almost think that, well, so I look like grandpa?
Yeah, I look like grandpa. Maybe Farel guess I am 70, more than 70 years old. Okay.
How old are you, Mr. Chandra? Mr. Chandra, how old are you? What about you?
Oh, 36 years old.
All right. 36 year old, and so the oldest one in here is Mr. Anton, yeah? 48. What about my age? Anybody can make a guess?
33. 40.
Any other guess? No, 17.
No. 23.
Well,
18.
What? Alhamdulillah. Well, I'm actually right now 40. I'm 40 years old right now. 40. I'm older than
in Mr. spiritnya 18.
So I'm actually older than Mr. Chandra. Mr. Chandra is 36, right? I'm 40 right now. Okay. Since it has already like 30 minutes late, it has to be already finished at 4:30, but yeah, we already discussing about a lot of things. Okay. Great opportunity to know all of you today. Hopefully all of you until the end of the meeting, we're going to be still like this. We're going to have high spirits, because usually in every class, in the first day we'll be going to be very full, so many people coming. But then after the last day, after the 20 days, everybody will going to be like only 2 people or 3 people. Hopefully all of you will going to be still coming until the last day of the meeting. Can you actually do that? Do you think you can do that, all of you guys? Okay. Good then. Hopefully. Okay. Okay. Thank you for today, class. So we are going to see you again tomorrow, and we are going to talk about pronunciation practice. Okay. Thank you, everyone. See you.
See you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you next.
See you.
Time. In tomorrow, right?
Okay, tomorrow. 3:30, okay? Not 4:30.